I hope you all are doing well. I am Devleena. I am pursuing my Master's in Forensic Science from Gujarat Forensic Sciences University. And today I am going to discuss on the basics of forensic ballistics. So first of all, what is ballistics? The general definition of ballistics is, it is a field of mechanics concerned with the launching, flight behavior and impact effects of projectiles. Basically, it is the science of firearms and projectiles. Now, what is forensic ballistics? It is nothing but the application of science of ballistics for the purpose of court of law. Colonel Calvin Goddard, who was an army officer in US Army, is known as the father of forensic ballistics. Now, types of ballistics. There are mainly three types of ballistics. Internal ballistics, external ballistics, and terminal ballistics. Internal ballistics is the study of what happens inside the barrel which leads to the propulsion of the projectile. Basically, from the moment of firing pin hits the primer to the time the bullet exits the barrel. Now, external ballistics, which is also known as exterior ballistics. It is the part of ballistics which deals with the behavior of projectile in its flight. And terminal ballistics. It is the study of the behavior and effects of the projectile when it hits and transfers all its energy to a target. But when the projectile hits a living target, the effect comes under wound ballistics. Now, there's a fourth type of ballistics which is known as intermediate or transitional ballistics. It deals with the motion of projectile from the time it leaves the muzzle until the only forces acting upon it are due to exterior ballistics, that is, the air resistance and the gravitational pull. Now, what are firearms? These can be defined as a device consisting of a cylindrical hollow tube through which a missile or projectile can be projected in a particular direction by the force obtained by burning a specific quantity of gunpowder. The main components of firearms are barrel, chamber, trigger, and grip. Barrel is the long hollow tube of the firearm through which the projectile comes out. Chamber is the cavity at the back of the barrel in which the cartridge is inserted before being fired. Trigger is the mechanism of the firearm which initiates the firing sequence. And grip is the part of the firearm which is held in the hands. Now, firearms can be classified in various ways based on various characteristics. The first one is bore characteristics. So, bore means barrel. Firearms can be classified into two types, smooth bore firearms and rifled bore firearms. Rifled bore is the type in which the barrel consists of rifling. That is, the insides of the barrel have cut and uncut portions known as grooves and lands respectively. It gives a spinning effect or gyrostatic motion to the bullet, which helps the bullet to travel longer distances in straight path. Main ammunitions of rifle firearms are bullets, and for example AK-47, pistols, etc. Now, smoothbore firearms. Smoothbore firearms are those firearms whose barrels are devoid of any rifling, except for paradox guns. The main ammunition of smoothbore firearms are slug shots, buckshots, pellets, etc. For example, any types of shotguns. Now, based on loading characteristics, firearms can be classified into two types again. Muzzle loaders and breech loaders. Muzzle loaders are the ones where the projectiles and propellant charge is loaded from the muzzle end or the front end of the firearms. For example, flintlock pistols. And breech loaders are the ones where the ammunition is loaded from the rear end or the breech end of the gun. For example, Ferguson pistol, which is a flintlock firearm. Now, based on handling characteristics, firearms can be of three types: handguns, shoulder guns, and stand guns. Handguns are the ones, obviously, which are designed to hold in one hand and fire, like revolvers and pistols. Shoulder guns are the ones which are raised against the shoulder so that the recoil can be absorbed by our shoulders, for example AK-47. And stand guns are those which are mounted on stands during firing. For example, low machine guns, snipers, high machine guns, INSAS, etc. Now, based on firing action mechanism, firearms can be divided into three types: manual firearms, semi-automatic firearms, and automatic firearms. Manual firearms are those where in which loading of cartridge and ejection of used cartridge cases are done manually, following different steps. For example, modern hunting or sporting rifles, Winchester 1873, etc. Semi-automatic firearms are those in which one trigger pull leads to the completion of the whole cycle, the whole firing sequence, which includes the firing of cartridge, extraction and ejection of the used cartridge case, and reloading of the chamber with new cartridge. For example, shotguns like Remington 1100 or Luger pistols, etc. And in automatic firearms, the firearm keeps on firing till the trigger is held down by the user. The extraction of cartridge cases, the reloading of chamber, it happens automatically. For example, AK-47 and M16 assault rifles. Now there's this interesting thing known as GSR. What is GSR? GSR means gunshot residue, also known as firearm discharge residue. These are nothing but burned, unburned, and semi-burned particles which is deposited on the insides of the barrel of the gun, the hands of the shooter, the surface on which the shooter was standing, and on the target. Now, GSR is mainly composed of organic compounds as well as inorganic compounds like nitrates, nitrites, barium, lead, etc. Now, what are the types of evidences that are encountered at the crime scene which comes under forensic ballistics? Mostly fired empty cartridge shells and GSR is encountered in crime scenes. Then there are bullets and pellets which are recovered from the target, and the firearms which are recovered either from the suspect or from the crime scene. Now these evidences are collected and preserved very carefully, and these bullets, pellets and used cartridge shells, these are collected using rubber tipped forceps and should be preserved in paper bags with proper labeling so that chain of custody can be maintained. Now these bullets, pellets and cartridge cases, these are examined and compared under comparison microscope. And to detect GSR, various spot tests or color tests are done. For example, dermal nitrate test or sodium rhodizonate or Harrison-Gilroy test. And the qualitative and quantitative examination of GSR is done using various instruments. For example, ETXRF or energy dispersive X-ray fluorescence. Then there is SEM or scanning electron microscope, or ICP-MS, that is inductively coupled plasma mass spectrometer. Now what is the forensic significance of all these evidences? So from all these evidences, we get to know who is the shooter, that is shooter identification can be done. The identification of which firearm was used, it can be done. The time since fire can be determined. The range of fire can be determined. The trajectory of the projectile can be detected, and also the entry and exit wounds can be detected. Like entry wound is the wound through which the bullet or the projectile has entered the body, a living body, and exit wound is that through which the bullet or the projectile has exited the body. Now I have tried to cover the major topics in this video. I hope now you have a little bit of idea of what forensic ballistics is all about. Thank you for watching. Hope you all stay safe. Thank you.